does not have any presentation at all, in fact. Do you like it? Okay, so do you want to come and settle down so that we can get started? We still have two few minutes there. So I thought we'll just get warmed up and use this session, because this is going to be a very, very different session. And I hope you have as much fun being in the session as I have in facilitating the session, right? Okay, so I know we are a few minutes before it, but I thought since you guys are all sitting here, why not we get started, right? Time box should end on time, doesn't mean that it cannot start before time. At least that's how I like to see it, right? So one question to all of you, pay attention to that. How many of you were children at one point in time? How many of you are still children? Okay, that's good. I think we'll have some good fun there. What is it that's the best thing that we remember when we were a child or when we are a child? Playing. So we are going to have some games today. Does that sound interesting to you? And we are going to talk about some of the things in a very lightweight manner. Now, the first game that we will do is something that you can do sitting there, but after that, what we'll do is we'll get rid of all these tables and chairs. Does that sound good to you? So I will need all of us to self-organize, pick up these tables, and push them onto the corner of the wall so that we can have some free space that we can play around with, right? So let's start with the first thing now. How many of you think you are not creative? How many of you think that creativity is the exclusive domain of people like musicians, people like painters, people like theater artists, and the so-called creative things? Because we are all hard sciences people, a lot of us, right? So do you think we are creative people or not? We are? Okay, so let's have some fun of creativity to begin with, right? How do you make people believe that they are creative? Let's have some fun there. So we don't have any post-its right now. I'm being very, very improv kind of a guy today. So I wanted to also highlight that the best things in life are all improvisation. They don't have to be pre-planned. So I planned the game in such a manner that the only thing I have here as something different is actually that we are going to do a little later, which is playing cards. Do you all like playing cards? Especially during Diwali time, right? So we'll play cards today as well. This is the only thing that we'll need it, but everything else that you need is on the table right now. So what I need all of you to do is tear a piece of paper and maybe make two halves of that, and then I'll explain you what do we do next. Now, you all have pencils and you all have papers. If you don't have, just reach out, steal from your neighbor. The best way to have fun will be steal it from your neighbor. Okay, so here is what we are going to do. You should have two pieces of paper on which you are going to write two different things. One of it, you are going to write any object that you can think of other than smartphone. Because the only, I'm sure if I don't place this constraint, 90% of you will only think of smartphone. Okay? So I want to impose one constraint of that. You have to write any object. Let's say the object you write is water bottle. So on one piece of paper, you will write water bottle. On the second piece of paper, you will write, what do you do with that? So you use it for drinking. So you say water bottle and drinking. So you write an object and the activity that we associate that with. Simple, right? Just do that, and then let's take a minute, think of some object, do that, and then we'll go to the next round. And it cannot be that complex, right? Probably it is, because I said you cannot think of smartphone. Right, you did that. Let's see how many people have done that. Another 30 seconds? Okay. You guys are good? Okay, so now what we need to do is, on the same table or on a different table, all of you, okay, you all have two pieces of paper. You have written name of an object on one piece of paper, and you have written the activity that we do with that object on another piece of paper. Any activity. For example, you say water bottle, so you've written water bottle and then you have said drinking. You use it for drinking water, right? Let's say you have put shoe there and then you say protection because shoe is helping you protect your feet, for example, right? Now all of you hold the object paper on the left hand and the activity paper on the right hand, okay? Now each one of you, either on your table or anyone else, you give your left hand paper to somebody else. Just do it one round. So go clockwise and pass it on to somebody else. Only the left hand paper right now. Let it go in a clockwise fashion. No, no, just one hop is okay. Right? Have you all done that? Okay, now the second instruction. Now the right hand side activity, you pass on anti-clockwise, one hop. So you find someone else probably. Just go and just be a part of another group for now. Okay, have you all done that? So hopefully you have two very, very random objects by now, right? Now your task is that in the next 2 to 3 minutes, think by yourself and try to create an association of these two things. You probably have got something like a shoe and noodles, and you have no clue what to do with that, right? What we want to do now is take 2 to 3 minutes, work individually, and come back with some association of, can you build some association out of these two things? They sound very random, and those who can do that, we will encourage them to come and just stand up there and share some of their ideas there, right? So the creative ideas don't need a lot of expense there. What I'm trying to build here is a case where you can just think like that. Sorry, you have something to say? You're done that, so just hold on for a while. Let's just give a chance to all the people here. Think for 2 minutes, think out of the box. Don't think in the mental models that we always have that tell us that shoe is only meant for walking and the fork is only meant for eating noodles. For all you know, you might have got shoe and eating and you have to figure out what you do with that now, right? So let's see how creative this group here today is and let's see what, maybe we have some Nobel Prize winning idea here coming out actually. It's waiting, it's lurking in the darkness, and it's just waiting to pounce upon us if only we gave it half a chance, right? So anyone making any headway with that? You guys are making? Okay, so why don't we get started there? Let's start with you. Just, you'll all get 15 seconds to pitch your idea, right?
Okay, so I have on my left a bag, and on my right, watch entertainment.
Bag and entertainment.
Watch entertainment.
Okay, I think we'll have a microphone. Okay, thanks.
So on my left, I have a bag, and on the right, it's view entertainment. So my idea would be a smart bag, because whenever you travel on a bus, you usually have your bag in front. So if you have a smart bag, you can watch entertainment channels on the bag itself.
Okay, so you'll have a bag that's going to be good. Okay, thanks. Let's give it a big hand. Thank you. Anyone here?
So I have camera, and I have writing on the right-hand side. So I am a writer passionate about cameras, and I wrote a recent book on cameras.
There you go. Okay, anyone here?
Left side, I have a light bulb, and right side, I have to lift that.
You so have a?
It's a lifting. I have to lift it.
You have to lift a light bulb?
Light bulb. So
wow.
It is very careful. I have to handle this because it might break.
It might break? Okay, cool. I'll come there in a moment.
On my left, I have bus. On right, it's drive through quickly through traffic.
Birds and drive.
Bus.
Bus.
Drive quickly through the traffic.
Okay.
So it's only possible if the traffic rules are not applicable on me.
So the bus has to fly probably,
no,
only
not
then
fly.
It probably
I mean,
can.
You just drive through, the traffic rules are just not applicable to you.
Okay. Okay. Well, you probably got little, you got similar kind of ideas over there, right? So.
I also have a camera and writing, so I thought one of the ways we could apply this is have camera take snaps of, for example, road signs, etc., which could get saved as a file and useful for someone else.
Okay.
Go ahead. Even I have the same bulb and use for writing.
Bulb so is for writing? Okay.
Writing. So I can use bulbs, LED bulbs, you know, for writing signboards, you know, anything with the LED bulbs.
All right.
Okay, I have a book reader and I have running.
Whole room.
Is it like the Hunger Games kind of thing that spreads the fire or something? Katniss dress, right? Yeah, okay.
Hi, I've got a car on my left hand side and I have got activities, reading books and play games.
Please don't do that. Yeah. Very dangerous, right? Reading books and playing games while driving.
My creativity thought is like I got a driver so that in my car I can read books and play games.
Well, wait till he has the same idea, right? So,
I've got a watch and I've got a left side it's watch and right side it's bad habit of working all the time.
All right.
So I should have my watch well, set, okay. Have some alarm set so and ask me to go home and spend some time with my family.
Okay, that's a good reminder service, right? Maybe there is a business case for that.
So I have cookies on my left side and right, on the right. So basically, you know, eat cookies that give you the energy and inspiration to start off writing a new book.
Okay.
So I got a unique situation here. I got a pencil and...
Do you want to get up so that we can all see you?
Sure.
Thank you.
I got a unique situation here. So I got a pencil and the activity is writing.
Pencil and writing is unique,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. That's happened purely because two people selected, I think, similar thing.
Yeah, that you, right. You, now you know why I said no smartphones, please?
Yeah.
I'm so, sure you all would have got smartphones.
I mean, to be creative in this is difficult, but you know what I can do is I can think of a agile pencil,
okay.
Which will only write what is needed rather than...
That's an interesting idea, right? So only write whatever creates value for the customer. It stops writing, right? Let's give a big hand to him. Okay, so now what we'll do is, you go next, but after that, what we'll do is, you got it drift, right? What I'm trying to here drive you at is, sometimes we have a lot of random ideas which do not make sense by itself. They have to combine, they have to actually procreate, only then we'll get something new interesting there. A lot of them might be a lot of noise to signal ratio, but then over a period of time, we really start getting to it. So after you go, what we'll do is, we'll do a quick voting and see which of the idea was the most unique there, and give them a big round of applause, right? So only those people who think that they have a very unique idea in the interest of time will like to do that, but let's just go to you. Eating the pencil, yeah, that's the old way of sharpening it anyway, right? Okay, so you're already thinking 5 years ahead of time?
Unit of time.
Unit of time? Yeah, yeah, why not?
Not a second I would travel today, my own unit of time.
Yeah, we Indians have already created that. Okay, anyone else who has something radically different, something totally out of the box idea here?
I've got television and writing. So creative way of thinking is opening up.
Do we have a lot of room full of writers? Is there some coincidence here? Like every.
I think it's to do with the pencil pen that they're.
Okay, just because we gave a pencil.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm glad we didn't have anything else over there.
Okay, the idea that I have is open up the television and open up a box there and ready for comment, like the way we have it in Facebook or for the discussion or feedback or quick discussion on the soaps or whatever it can be. So enable your streaming in a different way.
Okay, cool. Okay, last two, one or two people, something totally out of the box.
Yeah, I had got a pen and keeping track of the time.
Pen and keeping track of the time, okay.
So maybe I'll have a digital pen where I can write down the schedule directly.
And so it will have a timer built into that, it will stop writing?
Yeah.
So beyond agile, right?
Yeah.
Now this is, pen is beyond agile.
Beyond
doesn't
agile.
Just deliver value, it stops. It actually is a unionized pen.
Yeah.
Right? So right. It stops work after some time. Right?
Yeah.
Great example.
Thank you.
So I have a card that launches me from Phoenix to Bangalore in 15 seconds.
Okay.
I'll be here with the team, attend the ceremonies, go back.
Okay, all right. So that's like teleporting, Star Trek kind of a thing going on here. Okay, whom do you think has the most cool idea that they were able to improvise upon? Anyone wants to, like a vote of voice or something? Agile pen? Agile pencil, the teleporting card? Anyone? What does this group like? All right, so there you are telling that, hey, guys, we don't like, it's like being in a theater, right? The fourth wall has just been dismantled. So the fourth wall has gone away, and we have gone from the realm of a theater into a storytelling where the feedback is telling performers how to change their storyline because the audience doesn't like it, right? Amazing stuff there. So I hope you got a sense of it, right? Some. There you go. All right, yeah. The only thing is some of the companies have already been making big size jeans, right? So they will be needing a lot of jackets just to carry it with us probably. But maybe there's a merit in that. Okay, all right, how was it? Was it fun? Do you believe that we can actually start doing something? A lot of times people don't believe they are creative by nature. They say, you know what? I spent 4 years logically analyzing stuff because I got this engineering degree. So that I don't have the rights to be creative anymore in the office. But that's not it. It's so simple as people just recombining some of the stuff here. So that was one game that I wanted to just play and kind of do that. The second game that I want to play is how many of the people in this room love, they are in like total hopeless case of in love with the hierarchy. How many people in this room love 27 layers of hierarchy in their organization? From your response, I think a lot of you do that. So we are going to play a game. And that game is all about how hierarchy or the titles, and we are a society, especially in India, I'm going to be a little more critical and a little more below the belt here because we are sitting in India and most of us are Indians here. And I think we need to take it with a pinch, rather a boulder of salt, the critical self-evaluation that I'm doing for us. We hate hierarchy as long as we are on the recipient side of it. And the moment we are on the other side of the equation, we love it, right? We don't recognize that it's hurting a lot of open communication inside the organization. It's hurting a lot of free-flowing communication. So I'm going to play a game here, which requires all of you to get off your chairs. So my first question is, before that, I'll need your help. How many agilists does it take to move the tables to the wall? Because our first task is going to be here, that we have to create some free space, just so that we can move around a little more freely. So if we can have 15 seconds of your time, I need your help to self-organize and push them, and so that we create some open space here. Yeah, please. Okay, thank you. Just for a demo part of that, you just have to pull out one card without seeing what is there in the card. Okay. You have to keep it like this.
The front part?
The front part should be visible to me. So you just have to keep it, but you cannot see it yourself. And then what we'll do is I'll do the same thing. Okay. And for rest of, and then what we are going to demonstrate to the people is we will play our title. So if you get a king or an ace or a queen, then I will treat you like a senior, that 27th hierarchy guy, right? And if I get a 2 or 3 or a 4, you treat me like a, you know what it is, right? So let's see, we don't know what card we are going to get. I don't know what card I'm going to get, but they will have fun at our expense, right? Okay, so what we are going to just demonstrate, I don't know what I have here, but we are just demonstrating here how in a team thing, because that's what you all are going to do now. So, hey, Naveen, how's it going? Is the code coming along there?
Yeah, it's kind of fine. You don't worry about it.
Okay, no, I think you guys didn't complete the project last time. Last time, there were a lot of screw-ups happening, right?
No, that was last time. This time, we're good.
You're doing better than that?
Project, I don't think you're doing
no, good. I think we are doing good. I mean, we are actually planning to get some more budget for you guys.
No. I think you need to worry about your project. Not
is that so? Okay, we'll have to see that. Yeah, let's see that, right? Okay, so now I don't know what is my card, but let me guess it, and you guess later on for that, right? I think I have a 5. What do you have?
I think I am around 5 or 6, yeah, myself.
Okay. This is 4. 7. Right? How was it, right? Now what's happening is we are actually disrespecting ourselves. I'm disrespecting Naveen as an individual, as a human being, as a fellow professional. But I'm looking at his title and I'm really aligning my communication around the title because that's what suits me. That's what really happens to all of us. So what we are going to do is a game in which what we would like all of you to do is, in the next 5 minutes, meet as many people as you can when you will all be having this on your show, on your forehead, and you have to guess your level. From the responses people give to you, you have to guess your level. Are you a 3 or a 4 like what I was? Or are you a big guy like Naveen was? A little bigger guy than me probably. That's why he was like patronizing. He said, hey, come on, you take care of your project. I'll deal with my thing, right? I was thinking all along that I was that budget guy and telling Naveen, hey, how's your project going? Man, we'll get you some more people. And he said, no way, right? So we were getting into this kind of a thing there. So what you need to do is you have your card. You have to be honest about it, not to flip it over and see what's there for you. Talk to as many people. Try to have a simulated conversation in the hallway so that you talk to the people. And after 5 minutes, when I start speaking again, what we'll do is we will need all the people to line up here. The smallest of the cards, those who believe they have a small card will go in this corner, and those who believe they have the larger card, they will go there, and we'll try to line up all the people, right? And then we will have fun and see whether you will, when you will discover what card you actually have there. Does it make sense? So you, the flip side of that is that you get to meet some more people as well, right? And have some conversation like what Naveen and I were doing there. Now, just one very, very important thing. Some of these cards, my son would not let me enter the home again, so I need them back. Okay, now these cards are all there from 2 to the ace, and the only card that we don't have is this. Because I don't think it's fair that we have this card in the deck here, right? So what I'm going to do is I'll need one or two volunteers who can just distribute the cards and then let the fun begin. Thanks, Prasad. So just take one card, pick up whatever you would like. No, no, don't show it. You keep it reversed and just share and then just move around, mingle with people, talk to each other and try to guess your level. And see for yourself how the titles can actually impact the way we communicate with each other, right? I'm sorry? Ace is the biggest one. Ace is the biggest one in this case. We'll do that. We'll do the debrief right after that. Yeah. First, see the experience that. Okay, good. Go ahead. Okay. Okay. Sure, sure. We'll come to that. So why don't you go and experience it? We'll do that. Yes, yeah. Makes sense, makes sense. Cards are over? Okay. 2 deck the. Nahi, 2 diye, ek udhar diya. Keep changing, don't get stuck with one person. Keep changing, keep talking to different people. I think people are having fun. We'll know it in a moment. Keep talking to people if you find someone. Yes.
On the lower side.
Well, you have to find your level. Good. So, guys, keep moving. Keep moving. The fun will be when you keep moving and talking to different people, so that you can actually get to there. big ones there. Okay, so guys, keep moving. Small cards to my left and the big cards to my right. No, you cannot see your cards right now. You have to just go and line up in a line and see where you think you should be. The lower cards there, the higher cards there. So just, but you cannot tell people, right?
Yeah.
Lower cards left, higher cards there. Yeah, and follow the spectrum. Make the spectrum here. Be in a line. We want people to be in a line here. I'm sorry? The smallest card will be to my left to the door, and the senior most card will be there. And I want people to be in a line here so that we can see. And you have to really see where do you think you should be there, right? So please be in a line there. Let's face this side, because we have the camera this side. The highest is that side, the smallest are that side. So be in a line there so that you can actually, later on, when you turn over your cards, you will see that. So please keep coming here and be in a line here. Turn this side towards the camera, because when the recording is available, you will enjoy doing it. You decide, but the smallest cards are over there and the biggest cards
what
are over there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Start from there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Go right up to the ace. You cannot look at your cards as yet, right? You have to only guess whatever level you have guessed for yourself. Be that side there. So I think we are not aligned right now. Does anyone know what's the definition of a line?
Which side is high and which side is low?
Okay, so can we form a line here now that actually follows a single line there, and you try to position yourself without looking at your cards relative to where you see people? It's a circle. We have to make a line, guys. Everybody, please spread out as a line. Okay, for the last time, the smallest card, 2, 3, 4, 5, to my right, the entrance door, and the ones that's king, queen, ace, they go right up to the wall over there. Okay, so please let's spread out as a line there. Don't look at your cards yet. You still have to guess your cards, right, and be in there. Line, please. Line, please.
The lower side is higher.
Okay, so that's, you'll be here then. Okay, now how many of you believe, you can look at your neighbor's cards but not your own cards. How many of you believe that in relation to your neighbor's card, you are rightly positioned? Raise your second hand. Don't raise your first hand, which is holding the card. Okay, so now let's go on a count of three, and you can look at your own cards and decide whether you got the right one or not. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. Look at your cards. Did you guess your level right?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's have a debrief session right now. Anyone wants to share? Those who had a 2, 3, 4, 5. How was it to be the lowest form of life? You are 4. How was it to be the lowest form of life inside the organization? Did people actually make you feel small when you guys had the small cards? They were asking status, right? That's really bad, right? I mean, how dare they ask for the status report, right? Okay, any other people, those who got 2, 3, 4, 5, first tell me, how was it? They don't care? That's really bad. I think we should have communism in this country, right? Okay, anyone else? They told you that? Guys, come on, that was not... There's too much of pressure on that, guys. Hey, come on, guys. That's not fair, right? Oh, that's good. Okay. That's really, you got a good CEO. Okay. Awesome. You got a confused CEO? Okay. How was for people who were in the middle management kind of a thing? Those who got like 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 types. Oh, you got some respect? Okay, so you were really the people between rock and the hard place, and you got a lot of respect from people there. It was a mixed bag? Did people give you a hard time? Did the junior people give you? Okay. We know you are already really beaten down, guys, and it's nothing. Okay. And did what kind of a grief did senior guys give you?
Yeah, once I got a queen.
You avoided them? Is that what you did? Okay. So very patronizing way in which you got the message there, right? Okay, let's go to the senior most folks and listen to them. How was it to be the king and the queen? Great? Right? So power corrupts and absolute, power corrupts absolute. Okay. Oh. And you guys were having a power war? Or? Ah, there you go, right? All right, okay. So did you guys, the ones who were senior, did you guys actually, were you very disrespectful or condescending to the junior guys? Because that's what they felt.
I was deliberately disrespectful so that they can guess their card.
Ah, okay. So there you go, right? The games CEOs play, right? That kind of thing. So did people actually treat you like a royalty? Yes. You felt that way?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Right? Cool. Okay, let's give a big hand and we'll play one more round of this in a different way. Thank you. Now we will... Okay.
I want to share an observation. I didn't have a card, so I was just observing people. And this game was for one-on-one, right?
Yes.
So I was seeing people with, you know, if I can see high card, low card, middle card.
Yes.
Ah,
there you go. We all want to hobnob with the powerful and the mighty, right? Nobody wants to be with that. Okay, so we will change the rules a little bit this time, right? I need a help from all of you to give your cards back, and then you will redraw the cards. So somebody can start getting it together. This time, there is a slight variation in the process. You will all pick up the cards. You will see the cards, and nobody else will see them. You will put them in your pocket. And you will still go around talking to the people. Only you know your level. Others don't know your level. Okay, and let's see if there is a difference between how people communicate with each other when you know your level, but others don't know and others don't really care about it. Let's see, does that change my behavior towards myself and towards other people there, right? So do we have all the cards you can just distribute to the people? You know the cards. You will draw it and put it in your pocket after that. And don't show it to anyone. And then we want to compare and contrast your experiences this time, right? Make sense? Okay, so can we have all the cards with Prasad here? I think he's distributing now. So just go ahead, look at your cards, and then again talk to the people. Hopefully you will meet some more new people this time. So just talk to them and see how it... Just keep it with you. Don't show it to anyone. This time it was better. You actually felt much more free.
Was asking the status.
Nobody was asking status because they didn't know what you were doing, right?
Actually, I think in this scenario, even 2, 3, 4, 5 should ask status.
Yeah, they should go. How many of you think that 2, 3, 4, 5 should go and ask the CEO and say, hey, how do you think is the status of the company? I think that's a fair question to ask, right? Because the board members are anyway going to ask that question. So why not the employee in the trenches? Oh, there you go, right? Right, yeah. Right, but then at least you didn't have to, whatever it was there, you didn't have to actually show it to the people and keep it, like carry it on your forehead, right? So, okay. Any other? Everybody, I don't know, maybe I made the mistake of seeding the example with Naveen on the status report. There's a lot of freeloaders in this, right? Okay. So what is it that you think as an agile team? Yeah, I think somebody told that, right? People wanted to be next to the CEO and all. So there you go. We are going back to the respect that we owe to each other as individuals and interactions, right? We are not really talking about labels, hierarchy, and titles. and the corner offices. We are actually willing to respect each other as human beings. We are willing to acknowledge the face behind the name and not look at the titles and be stuck with that, right? So what is it that you feel we can take back to the organizations and to the workplaces? Is there some subtle message that we can give to the people and say how easy things can be when things are different there? Would you like to have people going around with the titles on their forehead? Is that the right way? Or? Okay, well, there you go. That's a very easy. Not there, right? All right, okay. Okay, but did by and large you felt that titles impede open communication? You felt that way? So we don't know, we'll not get judgmental. We'll only use based on the facts that we observed in this room. We felt that it was impeding open communication. It was making us a little more judgmental that, hey, I want to be rubbing my shoulders with the top dog and not really with some lower level, I don't even know, right? I mean, that kind of stuff, right? Anything else, any other key observations that you have?
There are few CEOs still, they are not able to leave their attitudes.
Ah. Oh, so there were still some old royalties that were still not willing to. Okay, that's why we took the cards back, but I don't know why. Yeah. Oh, is that so? Okay. Okay, so once the damage is done, it is done forever. Is that what we are saying? Right? There's no way to do it needs a brain surgery to remove that effect. Probably it has to be there, right? Okay, how was it? Did you enjoy that?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Let's give a big hand. We'll play one more game, this is on the self-organization now. Now, has anyone? Okay, if you all can just put your cards back here, thank you. Now, how many people in the room have played the Untangle game? Okay, so that's good news because most of you have not played Untangle game. So you will find something very new and interesting there. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's clear up some space here. I need actually a bunch of volunteers. I need volunteers in team of 8. Now, just a word of caution here. This is a game in which people will be holding each other's hands. So if you're not comfortable, you don't need to. Or find a group where you're comfortable doing that. I just want to kind of make sure that I respect everyone's private space here. What we are going to do is those 8 volunteers who are willing to hold hands of each other for 2 minutes, just come here and let's make units of these 2. Okay, so face off each other, 2 rows of 4 each. Now what you're going to do, we'll demonstrate it once. So I have 4 people now. No, hang on, I'll just explain you how to do that. So let's have 8 people who are there. Can we have a little space between this and the rest of the, the audience can be a little away from there. Who are the 8 people? Can you come a little further here? Okay. Now, just face off each other. We need one more volunteer here. Okay, now what you guys are going to do is, we want you to hold each other's hand as randomly as possible. So as randomly is, just make as many cross connections as you can. Okay, there's no opponent, you are all part of the same team, the 8 of you. So you might hold your right hand with the left hand here, and then you just go and create as complex something as possible. Go ahead and do that.
Just do it happily.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, we need a manager for this team. Do we have a manager here? Anyone wants to volunteer to be a manager?
Alvin.
You are a manager? Praful. Okay, thanks. Let's give him a big hand to manager, right? It's a tough job.
We're going to make them go under.
Yeah. So now what you have to do is, Praful, as the team, you guys have a manager. Okay. That manager will tell you what to do. His job is to untangle you. Now, there are only 2 rules for you guys. One is you cannot leave the hands. You have to keep holding it. And you have to only follow whatever your manager tells you. Okay, so now your manager has to do. Can we have one more volunteer to time keep and just to record the time, how much time it takes for this manager to untangle this team? Okay, so the aim is to untangle it so that we come out of this untangle. Praful, all yours. Let's see how fast can you do that. Yeah. I just want to illustrate that once, and then we'll do that.
Manager,
give up. Manager? Okay, go ahead. And I think all of us can be those nosy neighbors, and we can keep telling people, right? It's up to them whether they want to. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so the CEO is telling the manager, whosoever comes out first will get promotion. They will be made the manager for the next team. They'll be made the manager for the next team.
You want aerial view?
Hey, this is not the right way to do it, yaar. You have to do it differently. Yeah, yeah. Karne ka hai. I have got more experience.
He's a consultant. Okay, we have a consultant here. Okay, how much time they have taken already?
1 minute 25.
1 minute 25. We'll give them another 1 minute. Hey, you guys are not listening to your manager. Okay, we are making some progress here, finally. Okay. Now we'll. Okay. So let's do one more thing now. Now just come back, and this time your manager just got fired. Sorry, Praful. Okay. He just got fired because he could not accomplish the objectives. Now you guys have to self-organize. Nobody is going to tell you. The good news or the bad news is nobody is going to tell you how to untangle yourself. You have to figure out, and we're going to time you guys again. Now let's just, to be fair, just leave the hands, and we'll regroup it just so that we give a fresh start. Do it now, and we'll again time you guys and see how fast can you guys untangle yourself. Okay, let's go.
Hold it easy.
Okay, so you're ready to go now? Okay, you're all set? Okay. Let's go. Okay, you are all by yourself now. Oh, is that? Okay.
So it was for me. I have to get a phone call.
Okay, are they making any progress? What is their velocity? They're making some progress? Okay, you're complicating it?
No, they don't need a manager. Manager is redundant because manager, without manager also they're able to do so much.
Okay. All right, okay, guys.
Almost.
Let's see how fast this team can do
space.
That now. Yeah, we'll give them some more space, yeah.
Oh, yeah, nice.
We'll see what.
Oh, yeah. Almost.
You
can take help from outside also if you want.
Self-organized. Yeah, you can do whatever you have to accept. Be willing to step over and then bend down and do whatever it takes for you to do that.
Complexity and culture.
Yeah. See, you're getting all the help from people now.
So you're getting some advice.
Right. There, way to go. Yeah. Yeah, you just came to the Agile India conference, you're getting some best practices. Okay, are we there? Sorry. Okay, so a little complex, but we're getting there. Okay. So we have, I think we'll do one thing. You guys have actually managed to create a very complex situation, which I think a lot of us have never seen before, right? So let's restart there. But you get the whole idea there, right? Most of the time, what you will see is that the teams that are actually untangling as a self-organizing team, within 1.5 minutes, they will be done. Okay. So the whole idea of illustrating that is that when you are not really dependent on somebody, one single person, and we as a group self-organize, it makes it much more easier there. Now, I just want to, for all of us, if you want to organize your own groups of eight and do some untangle game, let's do that, just so that others can also have fun there. So just because we were, having fun at your expense, right? So now we can have some more fun at everyone's expense there, right? So those who want to do that, go ahead and do that. Let's have some few of the untangle games here. Are we okay with that? Okay, cool. So you can form as many teams as you want. And those who want to do, we can. You can have you guys can have your own team here. But people have to, I want everyone to be a part of that. Yeah, those will.
Time is 12,
right? I'll join, okay. Yeah.
You can join? Oh, okay.
But it's not answer.
Which way you want to go?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Oh, there you go. It was easy.
That was easy.
This was, yeah.
That's one thing.
Is that? You want that also? Okay. No, then we have a knot here.
No, there is a way.
Let's try, okay.
Let's all lie down.
Lie down. Ah, okay. And, okay, this is complex. This is a new version.
So you need to, kids are able to do somersault.
Okay.
So they are able to.
Oh, somersault.
So we do a somersault.
Okay, we got it.
Okay. How much time did you guys take? Less than a minute. Good. Good job. Okay, we have two teams going on here as well. Good. So we'll give another 1 minute and then we'll do a quick debrief and then break the session, right? Why does it not look like a circle? Is it only to me or to? It doesn't have to be. It may add as many people as you can. Yeah. Thank you. Tathagat. Okay, are you guys complete, done? One knot, we are not able to do that? Okay, you were able to do that? So any thoughts, any observations from people who participated in that? Some teams were able to complete, this is the first time I've seen teams were not able to do, actually. Team members can solve many problems if only we managers don't interfere, right? If the scrum masters don't interfere, okay. So they were able to solve the problem despite a scrum master? That's wonderful. That's awesome. Yeah. Okay. But then some rules have to be there, right? Okay. Who should decide which rules should be broken? The team should decide, right? Absolutely. Anything else from the groups that we had? Any other new? Okay. Okay. Awesome. Okay. Okay. Right. But you still came together and you started to trust each other's judgment when somebody said, okay, you go under here and then and do something, right? Okay, cool. So yeah, no, I think that was good. Do you want to just get one bonus game? I have one more game that I can share. We'll not have everyone play, but I need four people who will be able to sit on each other without chairs. So they will be actually hanging in midair on each other without any chair. Do you want to try that? It requires trust, agility, teamwork. So I need four volunteers who are comfortable that somebody has somebody is lying on their laps, actually. Just four. Can we get four chairs as well? We'll start with chairs and then remove the chairs. Thank you. See what is the way to do that. Yeah, you come here, you can sit like this, you can keep your legs out, that side. You can come here, and you can come here. Now what you will do is, the game is simple. You will actually fall on his lap, so your head will be on the lap. So that's the way we'll do that. Can you try that? Okay. Are you guys stable? Just move the chairs. Okay. All right, okay. Now we'll see if the magic happens. Okay? Now you guys hold on to yourself. You have to trust each other. Okay? You can hold each other's hands or find a way to do that. Okay? You guys are good? Okay. And don't worry about it.
Don't worry. Okay?
Okay, let's see now if the group can hold on. Okay, let's see if they can hold on. Do you want to keep going? Okay. You are comfortable? Okay, we'll leave it to you. You decide when you want to, when you are finished. Okay, All right, can we give a big round of applause to them? So this is a great example of how we can actually demonstrate how, what was it, what was going on in your mind at that time, all four of you? Right.
So we rested our hands on each other.
Right.
So that builded the balance between four of us.
Okay. Did you feel that you have to be interdependent on each other and you, it cannot be, right? You cannot be selfish about it. Everyone is dependent on that, right?
Yes.
So we actually, if we had more time, we could have done some competitions where we could have had four teams and let's see who can survive the longest in that position there, right? I think it's a great example of how you can see teams need to have trust. First is the faith in their own abilities individually that I can do that. And then secondly, trust among each other to be able to do that thing. Anything else from people who saw that? Would you like to do that? Go ahead and do that, otherwise do it in your own, right? And your, it's a great example for teamwork, yes.
So when you are self-organized,
yes.
And you have more courage to commit yourself.
Right.
So even though when the chairs are removed, so the, as a team, they could, they had more courage to.
They had come to a point where they could, they had the courage.
Had they been individual, that courage would not have,
would
been.
Not have been there, right?
Okay, great. Well, the session comes to a close. We have the lunchtime now. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed. I enjoyed doing it. Thank you. Enjoy those games.